Leia here from leiafrisette.com/mcat, and in this video, we're going to continue our discussion on balancing redox equations, looking at a complicated example in ACID. In the last video, we introduced balancing redox equations, including how to utilize this checklist. You can find that video, along with this checklist and more, on my website, leiafrisette.com/reactions. Say you're told to balance the following equation that takes place in ACID: Ag solid plus O2 gas gives you Ag plus aqueous. Remember that in an acidic solution, we expect to have an excess of H+, but we also expect to have water because the acid is dissolved in water. Taking that into consideration, let's begin. Remember the checklist. First, we identify the oxidation number of everything involved. Ag solid by itself has the oxidation number of 0. O2, which is in its elemental state, oxidation number of 0. Ag plus is a monoatomic ion with a charge of +1, giving me an oxidation state of +1. So far, so good. Next, we identify what is oxidized and reduced. I like to pair up the similar species in the reactants and products so we can identify what's going on. But we don't appear to have a complete reaction, because if I pair up Ag solid with Ag plus, I can identify that Ag zero goes up, or up, telling me that it's the oxidation half reaction. But what do I pair up the oxygen with? There's nothing else here. This is where I'm reminding you, this is an unbalanced reaction taking place in an aqueous acidic environment. This means we have water and we have acid floating around. And if it's an oxygen or hydrogen not shown, we are going to add that in when we complete the steps for balancing. So what do we do? We can either add an H2O here, recognize that the O in oxygen is -2, letting me know it's reduction, or we can do it this way instead. Let's start with Ag as our oxidation half reaction. Line up your arrows down the middle, and what do we have? We have Ag solid, omitting phases for simplicity, goes to Ag plus, and our reduction half reaction, well, let's only write what we have. We have O2 that has to get reduced, but we don't yet know what it goes to, so let's leave it as is. Now we go into balancing, starting with the oxidation half reaction. We balance the non-H's and O's, which is good because we have Ag. We have one Ag on the left, one Ag on the right. The atoms are balanced. We have no hydrogen, we have no oxygen. We're good to go. For the reduction half reaction, the only atom we have present is oxygen, so we have no non-H's and O's to balance. Next, we go to oxygen, and to balance oxygen, we have water. We have two oxygens on the left in the O2 molecule and nothing on the right, but to balance oxygen, we add in water. So if we have two oxygens in O2, we add two molecules of H2O. Now the oxygens are balanced. 2 times 1 oxygen is 2 oxygen. The last thing we balance is hydrogen, and now you see why we left it for last. Because if we first balance hydrogen, then balance oxygen to get water, every time we add water, we add hydrogen, which would give us more work unless we save it for the very end. We have 2 times H2O, which is 4 hydrogen, and so we add 4 H+ on the reactant side to balance. Now everything's balanced. 4 hydrogen, 4 hydrogen, 2 oxygen, 2 oxygen. Our atoms are balanced, so let's move on to charge. For the oxidation reaction, some of the reactants, 0, some of the products, +1. We want to add electrons to the higher number to bring it down. 1 minus what number gives me 0? 1 minus 1 equals 0, so we add +1 electron to the products. Now for reduction, some of the reactants is 4 from the positive hydrogen, 0 for oxygen, for a total of +4. Some of the products, 0. How do we balance? We bring the 4 down to 0. 4 minus 4 equals 0, so we add 4 electrons to the reactant side. Our atoms are balanced, our electrons are balanced. Now we want to make sure that we have the same number of electrons in the reactants and the products. So let's see. 4 electrons in the reduction half reaction, 1 electron in the oxidation half reaction. So we'll multiply the entire oxidation half by 4, giving me 4 Ag goes to 4Ag plus, plus 4 electrons. Now that the electrons are balanced, we can cancel them out. And now we can sum it all up. On the reactant side, we have 4Ag plus 4H plus, plus O2. On the product side, we have 4Ag plus and 2H2O. It looks like we're done, but we're not. We check for duplicates to cancel. We don't have any. Next, we'll check all the atoms. 4Ag, 4Ag, 4 hydrogens, don't worry about the charge yet. 2 times 2 is 4 hydrogens. O2 is 2 oxygen. 2 times H2O is 2 oxygen. The atoms are balanced. Next, we'll check the charge. 0 plus 4, 0. Gives us plus 4 on the reactants. 4 times plus 1 is plus 4, plus 0. Gives us plus 4 on the products. And we're good to go. Let's add the phases back in. And here we have it. 4Ag solid plus 4 protons plus O2 gas gives us 4Ag plus plus 2H2O liquid. Let's try another example. Say you're told to complete and balance the following reaction, where MnO4 minus aqueous plus Cl minus aqueous goes to Mn2 plus aqueous plus Cl2 aqueous. You can immediately identify this as a redox reaction because you have Cl2 as an element by itself and Cl- on the other side. Anytime something goes from an ion to a non-ion, that's your clue for redox. The first step is finding the oxidation number of anything that gets changed from the reactants to the products. Let's start with the simple ones. Cl-, its charge is the oxidation number of minus 1. Mn2+, is a monoatomic ion, so its oxidation number is the charge of plus 2. And Cl2 is a diatomic molecule with a charge and oxidation number of 0. That leaves us with a complicated MnO4-. We know that oxygen is minus 2 unless by itself or a peroxide, but Mn is the unknown. So we're going to solve this using the method I teach in the Finding Oxidation Numbers video earlier in this series by setting it up as x for the Mn plus 4 for the 4 oxygen times negative 2 for the oxidation number of oxygen equals the total charge, which is minus 1. Or we can simplify that and say 4 times negative 2 is minus 8. X minus 8 equals minus 1. Add 8 to both sides, allowing this to cancel, plus 8 on the products gives me X for the Mn is equal to negative 1 plus 8, which is positive 7. Next, let's figure out what gets oxidized and reduced by pairing up like species. Mn plus 7 goes to Mn plus 2. 7 goes down or is reduced to 2, giving me the reduction half reaction. Chlorine minus 1 goes up or up to chlorine 0, giving us the oxidation half reaction. We've identified what gets oxidized and reduced. Let's put the arrow down the middle, then write out our half reactions. For the oxidation half reaction, we have Cl minus goes to Cl2, omitting phases for simplicity. For the reduction half reaction, we have MnO4 minus going to Mn2 plus. Let's balance the half reaction starting with oxidation. First, the non-H's and O's, in this case Cl. We have Cl2 in the products and 1 Cl- in the reactants, so we simply put a 2 before the Cl-. 2 chloride ions gives us 1 Cl2, 2 on both sides. Next, we balance the H's and O's, which we have none, so we're good to go. For the reduction half reaction, let's start by balancing the non-H's and O's. We have 1 Mn in the reactants, 1 in the products. Next, we balance the oxygen by adding H2O. We have 4 oxygens in the reactants, so we add 4 water molecules to introduce 4 oxygens to the products. Next, we balance the H's, none in the reactants, but 8 in the products. 4H2 gives me 8 hydrogen, so I add 8 H pluses on the reactant side, and the reduction half is balanced. We have 8 hydrogen, 8 hydrogen, 1 manganese, 1 manganese, 4 oxygen, 4 oxygen. Our atoms are balanced. Let's move on to charge. For the oxidation half reaction, we have 2 times negative 1 is negative 2 in the reactants, 0 in the products. We want to bring the higher number down. That means 0 plus what number is equal to minus 2? 0 minus 2 is equal to negative 2. This means we add 2 electrons to the products. for a total of negative 2 to balance the negative 2. This is different from what we've seen before where we had 0 and positive, but it doesn't matter if it's positive or negative. The higher number must be brought down by negative electrons, as we saw here. For the reduction half, we have plus 8 minus 1 equals plus 7 on the reactants, and just plus 2 in the products. 7 is the higher number, so we bring it down. 7 minus what number is going to give us plus 2? 7 minus 5 is equal to 2, so we add plus 5 electrons to the reactant side of the reduction reaction. Our atoms are balanced, our charge is balanced. Now we want to make sure we have the same number of electrons so we can cancel. Up to this point, we had one and another number, so it was very easy to multiply one to get the other. In this case, we have 5 electrons and 2 electrons. One is odd, one is even. So the only way to get them close to each other is to find that least common multiple. In this case, 5 times 2 gives me 10. That means I have to multiply the entire oxidation half reaction by 5 and the entire reduction half reaction by 2. Let's distribute the numbers. 5 times 2 is 10 Cl minus. 5 times 1 is 5 Cl2. 5 times 2 is 10 electrons. 2 times 5 is 10 electrons. 2 times 8 is 16 H+. 2 times invisible 1 when there's nothing given. 2 times the invisible 1, and 2 times 4, which is 8. Now that the electrons are the same, we cancel them out. 10 electrons in the reduction half, 10 electrons on the oxidation half. Almost there, let's sum it all up. Again, this is why it's so important to keep that arrow right down the middle. What do we have on the reactant side? 10 Cl- for oxidation, reacting with 16 H+, and 2MnO4-. On the products, we have 5Cl2 from oxidation, 2Mn2+, and 8H2O from reduction. Do we have any duplicates? Nope, everything looks good. Check everything. Let's start with the atoms. 10 chlorines, 5 times 2 is 10 chlorine. 16 hydrogens, 8 times 2 is 16 hydrogen. 2 manganese. 2 times 4 is 8 oxygen, 8 times 1 is 8 oxygen. Atoms are balanced. Let's check on the charges. In the reactants, we have minus 10 from 10 Cl minus, plus 16 from the H pluses, minus 2 from the 2 manganates. That's minus 10 plus 16 minus 2, which is equal to plus 4. On the products, we have 0, 2 times plus 2 is plus 4, and 0. Plus 4 equals plus 4. Our atoms are balanced, our charges are balanced, our redox reaction is balanced. Whew, that's a mouthful. If you thought this was exciting, meaning annoying, wait till you see what happens when you have to balance in base, which is exactly what we'll do in the next video. First, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on any new MCAT videos. Then visit my website, leahforsci.com/reactions, for the MCAT stoichiometry and reactions practice quiz and cheat sheet. The link again, leahforsci.com/reactions.